So is this set the motivation in order to become enlightened for the benefit of all sentient beings? And for world peace? And national peace, and family peace, and inner peace.
Dhani Lama Yeah, and I draw more one pony. Lama Chopa.
Jing keng han keng pen keng
Nam kaji siva sundu so.
Verse 38. You have renewing bodhisattva and tantric vows on yours?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, let's do that. You guys lead it. I will follow you because I don't have it in front of me.
In English.
Bodhisattva vows?
Yeah, bodhisattva and tantric vows. Uh-huh. Yeah, everything. You guys lead it though because I don't have it in front of me.
The purpose of my life is to free all my kind mother sentient beings from suffering and to lead them to enlightenment. To do this, I must receive enlightenment. Without the Bodhisattva's vows, this is not possible. Therefore, I'm going to take the Bodhisattva's vows for the benefits of all my kind mother sentient beings. I go for refuge to the three jewels. I confess intuitively all negativities. I rejoice in the virtue of migrating beings. I hold with my mind and Buddha's enlightenment. I go for refuge until my enlightenment, the Buddha, the Dharma, the Supreme Assembly, in order to fully accomplish the purpose of my life and others, I shall generate the mind of enlightenment. Having generated the mind of Supreme Enlightenment, I shall invite all sentient beings to be my guests. I shall undertake the pleasing supreme conduct of enlightenment, may I accomplish Buddhahood in order to benefit migrating beings. Another three times?
Yep. Two more times, yeah. I go for refuge.
I go for refuge until my enlightenment.
Go up. You missed a verse. Yeah, there. Yeah,
I go for refuge in the three jewels. I confess individually all negativities. I rejoice in the virtue of migrating beings. I hold with my mind the Buddha's enlightenment. I go for refuge until my enlightenment to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly. In order to fully accomplish the purpose of my life, I shall generate the mind of enlightenment. Having generated the mind of supreme enlightenment, I shall invite all sentient beings to be my guests. I shall undertake the pleasing supreme conduct of enlightenment. May I accomplish Buddhahood in order to benefit migrating beings.
To
the three jewels, confess individually all negativities. I rejoice in the virtue of migrating beings. I hold with my mind the Buddha's enlightenment. I go for refuge until my enlightenment to the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly. In order to fully accomplish the purpose of my life, myself, and others, I shall generate the mind of enlightenment. Having generated the mind of supreme enlightenment, I shall invite all sentient beings to be my guests. I shall undertake the pleasing supreme conduct of enlightenment. May I accomplish Buddhahood in order to benefit migrating beings.
So then you think that any vows that were broken have been restored, and any kept purely have increased in strength. And then the tantric vows.
That
end. Our suffering and samsara is so unbearable.
I must free them from suffering and lead them to enlightenment as quickly as possible, without even delaying 1 second. To do this, I must become enlightened. Without tantric vows, this is not possible. Therefore, I'm going to take the tantric vows for the benefits of all my kind mothers, sentient beings. O Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, please listen to me. I, Sigal, from now until I reach the essence of Buddhahood, shall generate the sacred, peerless bodhicitta. Just as all Buddhas of the three times have ensured themselves of awakening.
So just stop for a sec. So when it says I, then you say under your breath your tantric name. So you can say to the Buddha family that dropped at the time of your empowerment. And if you don't remember, then you use the head of the Buddha family of your Yidam. And if you don't remember that, you use Akshobhya. So, but you do it right under your breath, so no one else can hear. So we'll just do that bit again. All Buddhas and Bodhisattvas,
please listen to me. I,
from now until I reach the essence of Buddhahood, shall generate the sacred, peerless bodhicitta.
Just as all Buddhas of the three times have ensured themselves of awakening by generating aim.
I shall pledge to uphold the vows of the Buddha lineage, to rely on the peerless triple gem,
Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha, and the three disciplines of observing proper behavior, gathering
virtuous Dharma, and benefiting sentient beings. I pledge to uphold the Vajra veil and mudra of the great Vajra lineage,
and to honor my teachers.
I pledge to practice the four types of giving 6 times each day,
keeping in line with the delightful commitments of the great Brahma family.
For the great Padma lineage, I pledge to uphold individually the holy dharmas that arose from great enlightenment.
Those are the outer, secret, and three vehicles. For the great supreme karma lineage, I pledge to uphold all vows well, and to make as many offerings as possible. I should generate the vows of peerless bodhicitta for the sake of all, and uphold all samayas without exception.
I shall uphold
all the general.
I shall deliver those not delivered,
liberate those not liberated, give birth to those unable to breathe, and place all beings in the start beyond sorrow.
So go back to the beginning. And then we'll do the first bit and then jump down to the abbreviation.
That's the beginning?
Yep, so do that stanza and then we'll jump. All Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
Can you say again the name?
I kind of don't want to because you're filming it. But it's,
if you don't remember.
If you don't remember, think about Shobhya.
Okay,
it's fine.
Shobhya.
Yeah.
Okay. All Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, please listen to me. I.
From now until I reach the essence of Buddhahood,
shall generate the sacred, fearless bodhicitta, just as all Buddhas of the three times have ensured themselves of awakening by generating it.
And then jump down. Right there. I shall uphold all the general and specific tantric vows and commitments of the five lineages
without exception. I shall deliver those not delivered, liberate those not liberated, give breath to those unable to breathe, and place all beings
in the state beyond sorrow. Back up. Back up. All Buddhas,
please listen to me. I, from now until I reach the essence of Buddhahood, shall generate the sacred pureness of bodhicitta, just as all Buddhas of the three times have ensured themselves of awakening by generating it.
Going down. I shall uphold
all the general and specific tantric vows and commitments of the five lineages without exception. I shall deliver those not delivered, liberate those not liberated, give birth to those unable to breathe, and place all beings in the state beyond sorrow.
So I think that any vows that have been broken have been restored. And any kept purely have increased in strength. And then when we do this in a public setting, before each of these vows, you just say, this is for people that already have them. If you don't already have them, just meditate on bodhicitta. So when you're doing this in a big group, just say that before you do that bit. Then we go on to the seven limb prayer.
Jawe Nam Ka La Da.
positive actions of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, in particular our gurus, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, Omdze Rinpoche, all of our precious teachers, every second of every day for sentient beings. Rejoicing in all of the practitioners all over the world, whether in retreat or in study or in daily life with ordinary jobs bringing the Dharma to their daily lives. Or working in aid organizations and charities. People living ethically, working with right livelihood. And our own positive actions. And then for verse 40, visualize that you're offering a giant Dharma chakra to all of the Buddhas. Requesting the guru to live long.
Dancing compelwe konzo do pose Josom kwa wele montoro Pahata so do de gondo shop ten shom.
Oh, Thank you. gems on the table. Oh, my Lord, until you'll on faith in day day. And my whole dump of the dead of for sins in that of drug age in love pay. Some may do so chill get so deep. Doctor to gems so numb and stable. Oh, my Lord, until you fell on faith in day day. Emma Hogan, they got an obstacle. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in the pays of the goofy, so tell get so deep. Thought you some gems on the table. Oh, Mahu, to you fell a whole days in day day. Emma Hogan, a room as he could see. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in the pays of the goofy, so tell get so deep. Sakula makes on humble table. Oh, Mahu, to you fell a whole faith in day day. Emma Hogan, lots of men of two songs. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in love pay. Some may do see so chill get so deep. Now to one more lots of men table. Oh, Mahu, to you fell a whole faith in day day. Emma Hogan, to you fell a whole faith in day day. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in love pay. Some may do see so chill get so deep. He got lots of courses and table. Oh, Mahu, until you fell on whole faith in day day. Emma Hogan, your child said up to school. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in love pay. Some may do see so chill get so deep. Four inches so numb and table. Oh, Mahu, until you fell a whole faith in day day. Emma Hogan, to touch and on to stop. Four inches in the dumb dog age in law pay. The way to see so chill get so deep. Got your two gems so numb and table. Oh, Mahu, until you fell a whole faith in day day. Emma Hogan, they touch and on to stop. Fortunes in the dumb dog age in love pay. Daddy do be so chill get so deep. Now you send him so dumb and table. Oh, Mahu, until you fell a whole faith in day day. And a whole
faith.
were just to the people we hired for the tantra. During this song to move the human parts, which is also called song in the spring theme. So all of the offerings except for the water bowls need to come off the altar at this point. So if it was a big group, we would give one of everything to everybody and keep distributing until it was all gone. Because there's just a few of us, you can take the whole bowl and just transfer it over onto the kitchen counter and we can divide it up amongst ourselves.
And this stands here
for now. So just doing this part, I think it's good if one of the plates or something, like one of us gets the nuts and one of us gets the berries, because we'll need it later. So we'll just start doing some of the spring clean while you guys take care of that.
So one that you don't feel so good.
Start with the back of the assembly, so you do the lay people first, and then you do the monks and nuns in reverse order, ending with the most senior one. So you guys put in first, and then you finish with me. You don't need the incense unless it's dark outside, but it's good to just get into the habit because really songs should be done after dark. It's just sometimes logistically hard to make that happen. You do it after dark because that's when the bikinis bloom. But anyway, it's okay as long as you do it during the day. It's good to fulfill your commitment for high service tantra, especially mother tantra. So, okay. So then what you do is stand facing the door during verse 77. Lots and lots and lots, go out the door and put it somewhere kind of high, at least not on the ground. And, okay. So, we'll first bless.
Kind of high?
Mm-hmm. Somewhere high is good. If not high, at least not on the ground. So, you can just, my garden is here, and there's some kind of high-ish stones and stuff like that. We could just leave the whole thing. It's good if you hold the incense and sort of. Anyway, just put the whole plate out, I'll deal with it later. Normally you would do back at the empty plate. Yeah, you can take it off the plate sometimes, but anyway, today we'll just not worry about it. Okay, so we'll bless it for the credits. Thank you. So if you're leading, you continue to recite while playing all the instruments all the way from verse 78, 79, 80, 81, 82. And then when the person comes back after having prayed outside, you say 83 together and then start doing the Lama prayer. So here's where it's good to swap into English. You don't have to, you can continue in Tibetan, but it's nice for the people that don't like chanting, and it's nice for people to have the imprints of the whole stages of the path, so we usually do this in English. So from verse 83, just recite all the way until. Verse 114. Yeah, so from 83 to 114, we'll do in English. And so you go ahead and read it because your translation is the most recent.
Okay,
I'll follow you.
May the force of the spiritual living man become a self-made Buddha for the sake of beings, and by my generosity may I liberate the multitudes of beings not liberated by previous Buddhas. Supreme Field of Mary, my perfect pure Guru, through the power of heaven made offering and respectful request, I seek your blessing, Savior, and the very root of happiness and goodness, that I may come under your joyful guidance.
Yeah, let's just skip to the next LC. Yeah.
Realizing how this body of liberties and illness is found by once, is difficult to obtain, and is quickly lost. I seek your blessings to make it worthwhile and take the essence, without being distracted by the meaningless affairs of this life. And yes, at this searing blade of suffering in the lower realms, I take heartfelt refuge in the three precious gems, and seek your blessing that I may eagerly strive to abandon all negativities and accomplish the accumulation of every creation. Rather, be tossed in these waves of karma and mental affliction, like that the many sea monsters of the three kinds of suffering, I seek your blessing to develop an intense longing to be liberated from this infinite and frightening great ocean of existence, having abundantly mind that views this undergirded prison of cycling existence as a pleasured world, I seek your blessing to hold the three trainings of the treasure of the superior's wealth, and thereby to uphold liberation's dharma. Consider how all these miserable beings have been my mother, and have raised me with kindness again and again. I seek your blessing to develop a fearless compassion like that of a loving mother or her
child.
There is no difference between myself and others. None of us wishes for even the slightest of suffering, or is ever content with the happiness we have. Realizing this, I seek your blessing that I might generate joy for the happiness of others. This chronic disease of cherishing myself is the cause giving rise to my unsolved suffering. Perceiving this, I seek your blessing to blame and destroy the monstrous demon of selfishness. The mind that cherishes mothers and places them in this is the gateway leading to infinite qualities. Seeing this, I seek your blessing to cherish these migratory beings more than my life, even should they rise up as my enemies. Enriched beings labor only for their own end, while the able ones work solely for the welfare of others. With the mind understanding the distinction between the failing of one and the advantage of the other, I seek your blessing to enable me to equalize and exchange myself with others. Cherishing myself is a doorway to all loss, but cherishing my mothers is the foundation of all qualities. Hence, I seek your blessing to enable me to exchange myself with others.
So the next verse, we do slowly in Tibetan three times while meditating on Tonglen normally. But today, using my voice, so let's just do it in English.
Okay. And the perfect, pure, compassion guru, I seek your blessing with all the activities of aspiration and sufferings of mother's mother. May without exception reckon upon you right now that I relieving my happiness and virtues to others, all my virtues may experience happiness.
And thus,
pure compassion and pure, I seek your blessing that all infinities, obscuration, and suffering for the mother mind readers may without exception ripen upon you right now, and that by giving my happiness and virtues to others, all my virtues may experience happiness. And thus, perfect pure compassion and goodness, I seek to that all negativities, obscuration, suffering, the mother my readers may without exception ripen upon me right now, and that by giving my happiness and virtues to others, all my virtues may experience happiness. And beings are filled with the fruits of negativity and unwished for suffering for them from the brain. I seek your blessing to take these miserable conditions of the past by seeing them as causes to exhaust the results of my negative karma. In short, no matter what appearance arises, by either good or bad, I seek your blessing to transform them into a path increasing the two little sugars. To the practice of the five forces, the consensus of the entire Dharma, and thus to meditate only on mental happiness. I seek your blessing that I relieve evade everything and may lead to meditation. The skillful means possessing the qualification, and that I may make liberties and endowments greatly meaningful. Through practicing the advice and pledges of thought transformation, in order to rescue all my creatures from the vast seas of existence, I seek your blessing to train only in bodhicitta, through love, compassion, and superior intention, conjoined with the technique of mountain breathing and taking upon the breath. I seek your blessing that I may eagerly endeavor to put into practice the three Mahayana moral codes, and to restrain my mind stream with pure vows of the conqueror's children. It's a single path joined by all the truths one of the three times. Seek your blessing to complete the perfection of generosity through the guiding teaching of increasing the mind at ease without attachment, namely transforming my body, wealth, and collection of the virtues of the three times into the object desires of each and every sentient being. I seek your blessing to complete the perfection of moral discipline, not transgressing the bounds of the Kamaksha and Tantric vows, even at the cost of my life, accumulating virtues, dharmas, and accomplishing the purpose of sentient beings. Should even all the beings of the three realms, without exception, become angry at me, humiliate, criticize, threaten, or even kill me, I seek your blessing not to be agitated, but to complete the perfection of the patience that works for their benefit in response to their harm. Even if I must remain for an ocean of eons in the fairly hills of Odishi, for the sake of even just one sentient being, I seek your blessing to complete the perfection of the out of compassion and continuing strives to supreme enlightenment, having abandoned the false thinking and education. I seek your blessing to complete the perfection of the mental stabilization through the samadhi of single point of placement, the initial reality of all phenomena, the lack of true existence. To complete the perfections of wisdom, through the space like yoga of single-minded placement upon ultimate truth, conjoined with a great bliss induced by the discriminating wisdom analyzing suchness, I seek your blessing to perfect the samadhi on illusion by realizing how often an inner phenomena, like true existence of still appear, like an illusion, a dream, or the moon's image on the sea lake. Samsara and nirvana lack even an atom of inherent existence, and causes and effects independent arising are inevitable. I seek your blessing to screen the meaning of Madhujuna thought, that these two are mutually complementary and non-contradictory. Then, crossing the depths of the ocean of Samsara, through the kindness of my captain Vajradhara, I seek your blessing that I may hold my vows and pledges, the roots of cities dearer than my life. and seek your blessing that whatever appears may arise as a deity, having cleansed all stains of ordinary appearance and blasphemy, with the first stage yoga of transforming the
earth
into the three bodies of the world. I seek your blessings to actualize in this life the path uniting the light and the illusory body, which arises from placing your feet, my Savior, in the eighth petal of my heart, at the very center of my central septama. In my time of death, come before I have completed the point of the path, I seek your blessing that I may secure land through the instructions of correctly applying the five forces, for the Guru's transference, the force means to enlightenment.
In short,
I seek your blessing, my Savior. So that all my temporal and ultimate wishes, without exception, may be effortlessly and spontaneously fulfilled.
Okay, so then verse 15, we switch to Tibetan.
Thank you.
perfect.